The Constituent Assembly. The Constituent Assembly was formed in July 1946, and for the first meeting, it held its meeting in December 1946. What is this Constituent Assembly? Constituent Assembly is set up with a purpose to draft a constitution to an independent India. The Britishers have passed the Indian Independence Act in the British Parliament, and by the time it gets the approval and becomes an act, they have intimated the Indians to draft their own constitution, because very soon they are going to grant freedom for our country. So with the news of that, a Constituent Assembly was elected, not on the universal adult franchise principle, but at the limited voting itself, an interim Constituent Assembly was elected. And after the Constituent Assembly was elected, in that we have nearly 300 odd members. After the partition of India and Pakistan, the Muslim leaders went towards Pakistan's Constituent Assembly. So only 299 members were the members of the Constituent Assembly at that time. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was the president of the Constituent Assembly, while Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairman of the drafting committee. So under the able leadership of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the Indians, especially the Constituent Assembly leaders, have taken up the great mammoth task of drafting a constitution to an independent India. It took nearly 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to draft the entire constitution and finally to get into place. It's on 26th of November 1949, the parliament has agreed and given a constitution to itself by Indians, to the Indians itself for the future generations. And to mark as an anniversary of this one, we adopted it on 26th November 1949, but it will come into force from 26th Jan 1950. So on 26th Jan, that's why we celebrate the Republic Day as a mark of anniversary of the day when the constitution came into effect. And this is a brief introduction of the drafting of the Indian constitution. What actually means the drafting of the Indian constitution? Is it truly acceptable that the leaders of a microscopic community of India have drafted a constitution to our nation of a 100 odd crore people? So maybe at that time we have 60 to 70 crore population. So how can it be accepted today? And what is it in comparison with the other countries? How did Dr. B.R. Ambedkar manage and answer the questions? And how is it even today considered as a living document or a live document? Let's find out. Now, we all get a fundamental question. The constitution, which has been drafted 50 years ago from date or 60 years ago from date, how can it be accepted today? The acceptance of the constitution itself is a really a tough question. General point of discussion. We are in 2015. We all are born up with the new ideas and new thoughts, thinking and everything. The framers of the constitution were young in 1950, which means we are not aware of the society which actually was at that time. We do not know actually the meaning of the colonial system actually. We never faced any colonial problems. We are born in an independent India. So for you, a law which is stating or explaining about equality is just a law which is explaining what is the meaning of the word equality. But the people, those who suffered the colonial problems, those who faced the colonial atrocities, they knew the true meaning of what is equality. They feel it really free when they heard the word equality. So there is a lot of difference in understanding every word of the constitution by the people of the old generations and the present day generations. So there is a fundamental point that why should I accept a constitution which has been drafted very early, or around some 60-65 years ago? Now the answer comes to this is, the acceptance of the constitution was never been questioned by any social group or any political party in our country. When we look at the world around, we have seen the countries like Belgium, the countries like USSR, where the basic provisions of the Constitution are being questioned. The legitimacy of the Constitution has been questioned. Many constitutions are being rewritten, redrafted, because they were not suitable, and many of the social and the political organizations did not agree on certain ideas and the ideologies. India, the situation was different. Why? What gave the chance to have so diverse and different thoughts in the making of the Indian Constitution that it satisfies and justifies any question which has been raised by the social groups or the political groups? The answer is very clear. When the Constitution was being drafted, the Constituent Assembly had many social groups. The social groups, in the sense, when we look at the provisions which are present in the Constitution, before they became the provisions in the Constitution, they have been a part and parcel of the debates of the Constituent Assembly. When we talk about the Constituent Assembly, we also get certain doubts. Yes, Constituent Assembly, for a 30 to 40 years span, even after India got its independence, was dominated by the Congress party. So obviously the Constituent Assembly was also dominated by the Congress party. So we all may get a doubt, the 1% of voting only is given to the provincial legislature elections. So the Constituent Assembly was also elected on the similar lines. So how can you justify that there has been an equal representation or the geographical representation of all over India during that time? And how can the Constitution which is written during that time can be justified today? The answer is very clear and straight. First point, the elections were conducted, the Constituent Assembly was dominated by the Congress members, it is 110% right. The Congress party itself is a true representation of the nation. We have seen it when it fought for the Indian national movement. We have leaders who have diverse opinions in the Congress party itself, who have sharp differences in the thoughts, in the ideas. So it is not that the Congress has a similar policy or a unique strategy where all members have followed the same guidelines or accepted the same ideology what the head of the party says. We have different groups, different policies, different ideas within the Congress, and the geographical representation has been come up with the provincial legislature, who are also coming from different regions of that time. Even if you have universal adult franchise till date of that time, even that cannot justify of having a right constitution which we have today, because the diverse of opinions is a major advantage. When we have universal adult franchise, we have many representatives. When the many representatives are coming within the Congress and the other than Congress, you get opinions of people who are having diverse opinions, who are having different ideas on different topics or different subjects. So these all were discussed thoroughly in the Constituent Assembly of that time. And drafting a constitution was not an easy task. They have nearly 7 committees. All these 7 committees have members who thoroughly checked all the other constitutions which are available till date of that day, and then they always checked whether these constitution or these laws are suitable to our situations or not, whether we can implement them in our social context, because India is a very diverse country. They have taken the constitution laws like fundamental rights from the Bill of Rights of the Britishers. Then we have taken the union and state relations from the Canadian Constitution. Then we have also taken the strong union from the Australian Constitution. We have taken the directive principles of state policy from the Irish Constitution, the parliamentary setup from the British Constitution. These all, after considering all these things, they have drafted a plan which suits best to the Indians of their knowledge. After drafting a constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who was head of the drafting committee, drafted the constitution, verified it thoroughly, and brought to the Constituent Assembly for discussion. He read clause by clause, word by word in the Constituent Assembly, explaining each word in detail to everyone, every member in the Constituent Assembly. It took nearly 114 days spread over in 3 years, and after having thorough discussion, every word, every clause, every provision, every sentence has been discussed thoroughly, deliberately in the Constituent Assembly. Many of them have raised their doubts on this, on every word, every section, every debate. They have all the records of the debates, and nearly 2000 amendments are being changed or made after the doubts are been clarified. And finally, we got the Constitution in place. It took nearly 2 years, exactly 2 years, 11 months, 18 days to draft a constitution to our country, which is the lengthiest written constitution in the world till date. This lengthiness is nothing but actually it explains every word and every clause in detail. What would be the action taken by the government if this kind of act has been performed by a citizen or an individual? What should be the action taken by the state government? What should be the action taken by the government of the union level? What should a citizen do? What a citizen should not do? What are his rights? What are his duties? What are his other things which he should not perform? Everything has been explained detailedly in the Constitution. And after drafting the Constitution, once again they have read it, and everybody has been satisfied till that date, and they have fixed the basic structure of the Constitution by that time itself, and made sure that every word and everything has been recorded. And when they printed this, we got 12 bulky volumes of the Indian Constitutional Assembly recordings in making of the Indian Constitution, which is used to interpret the understanding of the Constitution for many years. Because even we are new to have a constitution. We never had a constitution earlier to this or prior to this. We are also entering into a phase where we have dictated rules and regulations which we all have to follow. These all things made India a special country, a unique country. And today, Indian Constitution is a role model for many other countries. Indian Constitution is being a guiding principle, a guiding book for many other countries which are newly becoming independent in the present century.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.